Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding quoting faith and reason written by Sanjay Hegde. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science, sociology and public administration optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about a very important concept, that is normalization of deviation. Now this normalization of deviation has been discussed in the context of how cow slaughtering, that should not have been a part of the Indian Constitution, how this issue of cow slaughtering should not have been discussed in the Indian Constitution. Now first of all, we need to understand why this issue of cow slaughtering should not have been given any space in the Indian Constitution and how it got introduced in the Indian Constitution. So pehle to ye janenge ki cow slaughtering ke upar samvidhan mein ek provision kyun nahi hona chahiye tha, and secondly we will be understanding how this thing, how this aspect of cow slaughtering entered in the Indian Constitution in the directive principles of the state policy. Now India had adopted a constitution, and this constitution was an embodiment of socialism, welfareism and secularism. Now out of all these three things, the most important thing that Indian constitution had always stood for, it was the principle of secularism. Now why I am emphasizing on this principle of secularism? Because when India got its independence, it got its independence and parallelly the partition of the nation also took place. Now Pakistan was created on the basis of two nation theory. Now this two nation theory or twin nation theory, it had the basis of religion underlying it and the basis of secularism lying underneath it. Pakistan was created with the logic that it wanted a separate Muslim nation, and India was created with the logic that India wants to be a secular nation. That was the message that was given by India when India came into being, when India got its independence. So secularism, it was one of the potent principles when it comes to the Indian Constitution. Now secularism means that you allow everybody to practice their religious rights, their religious views that they wanted them to be. So the Constitution of India in the beginning, it should not have addressed the food practices that the people belonging to a particular religion may like or may not like. So this should supposedly have been the logic that India is a secular nation. It will not be addressing anything related to the food habit and the food preferences and the food choices of the people. But when it comes to cow slaughtering, when it comes to buffalo slaughtering, this was added in the Indian Constitution with the logic of economy underlying it. The logic was given that the cow slaughtering should be practiced, should not be practiced, and the agriculture should be conducted in a scientific manner. Now this provision was added in the Indian Constitution under Article 48. Now this provision of the Article 48, it impinges on the state to make efforts to ensure that agriculture and animal husbandry is conducted on scientific principles. Now primarily it was inserted because of the religious preference of the Hindu rightist groups. They wanted to accord a lot of reverence and respect to cow. And this principle, this directive principle that the state should be making an effort to protect the cow should be inserted in the Indian constitution under directive principles of the state policy. So it was a kind of a normalization of the deviation. So we deviated from the principle of secularism in the constitution itself. So we challenge this aspect of secularism that was included in the Indian constitution. We negated this aspect of secularism. Humne isko side mein rakh diya aur introduced this issue of cow slaughtering in the directive principles of the state policy. Now, this normalization of deviation, this was further entrenched. This was further supported by the Indian judiciary. Now, we have two judgments. One is the 5-judge bench, other is the 7-judge bench. Now, in the 5-judge bench, in 1959, the judiciary has taken a stand that the complete banning of the slaughtering is not possible. So it has created three kind of conditions, three kind of subcategories under which the slaughtering is allowed and slaughtering is not allowed. And further, in the 7-judge bench, later on, judiciary has allowed the state governments to ban the slaughtering of the cows, to ban the slaughtering of the buffaloes. So power has been conferred onto the state governments by the judiciary by reading this Article 48. Now, when it comes to the Indian Constitution, this is a constitution that was designed primarily for the humans, and less credence, less importance was accorded to the animals. But by these judgments and by this normalization of deviation, we are actually aberrating from what Indian constitution really stands for. Hindustan ka jo samvidhan hai wo secularism ko ek potent principle maan ke chalta hai. But jab samvidhan bana to humne ye baat ignore kar di ki agar hum ye cheez add kar rahe hain ki banning of the slaughtering of the cows wala provision under Article 48, we are actually deviating from the principle of secularism. And judiciary ne bhi ye cheez ignore kar di. So primary, what is the primary issue in this entire editorial? The primary issue is normalization of deviation. Had Ambedkar would not have ignored this aspect, had Ambedkar would have addressed this aspect, had Ambedkar would not have allowed normalization of deviation, there would not have been this Article 48. So when we tend to ignore the aberrations and the deviations, it actually sets in the problems. And this is the problem that currently we are facing. Facing fundamental rights of the choice to eat what type of food that really we want to. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact us at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services classes. So whatever views I am presenting in the editorial classes, these views are not mine views. These views are that of Sanjay Hegde. I'm just decoding whatever he is saying. So this was all for the editorial decode. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.